Dover just a track that fits my style. You know, I think each team has a track that fits, you know, their company's style. Crew chief, driver, you know, all that stuff. And then every once in a while you get it where the driver, the crew chief, and the equipment, you know, it fits all three. And that's just been my situation in the 48 at Dover.
Teammates coming to the checkers. Jimmy Johnson wins at Dover.
Yeah, that was awesome. Yeah, he wanted to put some smoke up here for our interview, obviously.
To win there 11 times and honestly had a look at two or three others that got away from us. That's only because of the timing of the three major pieces. It just works for all three of us.
His 27th birthday was this past Tuesday. There'll be a lot of candles to blow out in victory lane at Dover. Jimmy Johnson sweeps the Monster Mile this season.
And to talk about me specifically, it really fits the throttle control requirement that it takes to be fast in an off-road car. You drop off into the corners, and how you use the throttle really sets the vehicle and the arc that the vehicle can turn.
McMurray three wide.
Then obviously you get in the corner and use your hands to point the car, but the throttle lift point is so critical in how you start the corner that it's just been very natural for me and it's worked very well for me over the years. Once it got away, I can think of Juan Pablo, knowing that I beat him on a restart and he decided to let off the gas, so I beat him a start finish line and got penalized late in the race.
Johnson gets going, Montoya does not. They come to green, the field stacks up behind Montoya, then separates and they're off to turn one.
Yeah, Juan Montoya just did not even remotely get going.
Restart violation.
Jimmy Johnson jumped the restart.
Well, it was
off the gas now, sir. Please look. I checked up to give him the spot back, but he blew it so bad.
Arguing the call.
I don't totally disagree. I mean, he took off, but Montoya didn't go at all.
He probably won't see it the same way, but I feel that that's the case. This is my video, so I'm going to stay the course. And when I think back to some of the special paint schemes I've run over the years, we always did really well with special paint schemes, but there was one that was just a little different and came with some props, and that was the Madagascar 3 movie that I ran at Dover.
Seventh Dover win. Jimmy Johnson wins the FedEx 400.
I got a wig prior to the race, and I thought, man, if I win the race, I'll throw this thing on. And sure enough, we win the darn race. And I said something to one of our crew guys, because he had it on during the race. Johnny Boydson, our engine tuner, had it on. And we've got a bunch of cool pictures of me wearing that goofy wig. The Afro Circus wig, I believe, was the name of it.
If everyone's attention here in the media center, we'll get started with our winner's press conference.
My buddy Beau, I met him, I can't even think how many years ago now, but walked in the driver's meeting. I saw a little boy wearing my shirt and a hat. He jumped up out of his chair when we made eye contact and he just bolted for me. And I went to hug him and I'm like, yeah, buddy, what's up? Then I realized that his oxygen little tubes was still connected to the big cylinder, and he was running so fast, he like ran out of line and ripped the stuff kind of off of his face and the canister fell over and he didn't care. He didn't check up. He was still just coming to give me a big old bear hug. And that was my first moment to meet Beau. Met his family, and they come to both races as long as Beau's feeling up to it and feeling well. Had the pleasure of taking him to victory lane. And more than anything, just having him at track on the race weekends. It's great to see him and his perspective and put a smile on his face.
Beau?
Dad, there's sharks.
I'd like your shark shirt, but
thank you.
We have a brand new Ally shirt.
Oh, that's awesome.
Thank you.
Yes, sir.
Just because we get around.